Hello there, I'm Josh, Modified Heaven, and this is my video unboxing, or rather re-unboxing and review of the iFi X-Can amplifier. This is not a DAC amplifier, this is just an amplifier this time around. They have the XDSD, which is a DAC amplifier, has a DAC inside, but this one only has the amplifier inside, so you'll need a DAC to give it signal. It has some sort of DAC inside because this one can use Bluetooth. It can receive Bluetooth signal, so there is a DAC or a decoder inside, but only for a Bluetooth signal. Now, I already did a little unboxing, as you probably just saw, so I'm going to just walk you through it. Papers just fell off. Not very important. This is the package. This is the unit. Very beautiful unit, as you can see here. I like the shape and the design of it. Look at it, just beautiful. A masterpiece, if you ask me, in every sense possible. Need to get this a bit louder, I think. I'm still adjusting to filming this way. I think I will get better with time. So, this is the unit. My camera will probably focus on the microphone before it focuses on my face. So, yeah. Now, I hope you don't see me too blurry. I hope. Now, the DAC unit looks like this. The amp unit looks like this. Very beautiful. I like the way it is presented by iFi. I have a few other DAC amplifiers to compare it to, like the Cord Mojo here. Mojo is one that I really love, actually. Why? Because Mojo is probably one of the most widely used DAC amplifiers by professionals, is at least in Romania. Most music producers and professionals use a Mojo. Why? Because the DAC inside is very, very good, very clear, very detailed. I don't know, they simply love it. They love the way it presents details. Very good DAC amp. Very good to compare with the iFi X-Can. Now, I also have the little XD 10 poke on my table, as you can see here. I really like the font used on this one, the Comic Sans inspired presentation, very casual DAC amplifier. You can use it while walking on the street and feel very natural about it. I think this is very easy to use portably compared to most DAC amps. Like, I have a very positive impression of Mojo at this moment, but I still think I would use the XD10 Poke rather than Mojo while on the street. Mojo has the advantage of having more driving power than the little XD10 Poke, but this is not especially relevant to this video, which is about the X-Can from iFi. This is the X-Can. It will get a few smudges and a few fingerprints. I have not found a way to avoid it. You will need to clean it from time to time, but that is entirely acceptable for a DAC amp. I mean, acceptable. Now, this is how you open it. You keep it the wheel pressed, then it is open. It is red because I was listening to just a second to these bad guys with it. The iFi man Sundara. I love saying that. Sundara, yeah. Now, this is how they look. This Sundara is quite interesting as a headphone. This is how they look together. About how they work together, though, they work very well together. Why? Because this has a lot of power. It can drive Sundara very well. And iFi integrates a little bass boost function to their X-Can series, which is different from the one employed in the XDSD series. As you can see here, I hope it will focus. There are three positions possible to the new X-Base 2 implementation. The three positions are bass, presence, and bass plus presence. I should probably explain what each does. First, the bass enhances the sub bass of the unit, so something like Sundara gets a lot of sub bass and sub bass hits, becomes very deep as a headphone, and this one was quite a bit mid-range forward, so they were quite well together. On the other hand, the presence settings the present setting will enhance the thickness and warmth of the entire sound. So basically you are getting a thick and warm mid-range. The presence works well with very cold or very bright headphones and earphones. On the other hand, the bass plus presence is probably what most people would have this set at most time if you want a thicker and more powerful sound signature. Now, the bass is what gives it the hit, the sound. Usually the bass gives the sound the explosion and the impact. So if you want a deeper and more powerful impact, then the bass setting will help with that. Sundara really is helped by it. Now Sundara is also helped by the 3D Plus setting found on the EXD, on the X-Can. As you can see here, it has two little settings, one out of which only one is lit right now. So let me lit both. This is how it looks when both settings are lit. The two little LED lights here are being lit. This means that both the X-Bass and the the 3D Plus soundstage setting is employed. This results in a very different sound. It is more V-shaped than the original sound it has. Now, of course, let me grab something really quick. Sundara is not the only headphone that works very well with it. The Crozon CZ1 also is driven quite well by the X-Can. The CZ1 is also helped by having the bass setting turned on and also by the 3D soundstage. Although those have a really huge soundstage already, they are still better when you turn on these settings. So, very useful settings on the X-Can. Going forward, I apologize, I need to go and take some things. Now, this is the Ultrason Signature DXP headphone, a headphone I really love and a headphone I really enjoy. I really love this one. Very, very good with metal and all kinds of metal. Very lovely headphone. I am quite into it. Now, this is also driven very well by the X-Can. So X really can drive headphones well. X-Can, yeah. I would say that X-Can gives the Signature DXP a really wide soundstage, even a little wider than they typically have. And I like employing the X-Bass 2 on the bass only setting. No presence, because it becomes way too warm for my tastes. But both the bass and the 3D settings are left employed for the Signature DXP, and although it doesn't require them to, it sounds much better with them employed. I really enjoy having both settings employed with the Signature DXP. Who knows? This can do a lot of wonders. The last headphone I'm going to talk a bit about with this one is... just a second, I'm back. The Brainwaves HM100 series. Now, it can also give them a very good sound, lots of power, very impactful sound. And if you do not engage the X bass or the 3D Plus setting, it actually makes them more natural, because it will make them a bit more forward, which in results gives them a slightly more forward mid-range, which was quite recessed on the HM100. A little side note, I do not consider a recessed mid-range something bad. I consider that having a recessed mid-range can be quite good for a headphone. Why? Because it gives you a wide soundstage. The more recessed the mid-range is, usually the more wide and expanded the soundstage is. So you are getting sound from, you are getting sound effects from your entire sound field around you. Now, to talk a bit about its main signature, it is quite neutral and linear. I think it is very good for driving most headphones out there. It has a good amount of instrument separation, very good details. Actually, it is insane how close, it can get to something very expensive, like the MyTech Brooklyn DAC Plus, which I have here. I think it is visible in the video. I would unplug it and actually let's do that. Let's unplug it and show it to you. Just a second. I should turn it off before unplugging it, actually. Okay. Let me just get it out there for you. Now, up. It is quite heavy. Actually, the MyTech Brooklyn DAC Plus is very heavy. Much heavier than my typical portables. Now, this is the unit. The MyTech Brooklyn DAC Plus. As you can see here, very beautiful unit. Yes, it looks nice. Now, it is crazy how close something like X can get to the Brooklyn DAC Plus, which Brooklyn DAC Plus is a very expensive DAC amplifier. This one runs for way more, like in the $1,000 to $2,000 price range. Now, this one is absolutely outstanding. I love the MyTech Brooklyn DAC Plus. It is one of my favorite DAC amps. And I mean, there is no shocker. It is one of the most expensive ones I tried. So it is natural they did a good job with it. I expected nothing less. I would have been shocked if it wasn't this good, to be honest. On the other hand, let me put this back here. On the other hand, this one can get shockingly close, not quite as good as the Brooklyn DAC Plus, but I think nobody expected it to, and nobody really could design it to. It is small, it is portable, it gets shockingly close to it. This is a portable. Now, about its portability, I'm not quite sure how to put this, but I would strap this to a player, to a music player, audiophile music player, like I think it would go very well strapped to something like the FIO music players, if you'd like, or I don't know, something which has a line out, because I would not use both the XDSD and the XCAN strapped to a smartphone. I think that would be quite excessive and would be impractical. I mean, having two of those strapped to a single smartphone, that is not quite portable. So I would use this with an FIO player. I actually think it can give some improvements, especially to the entry-level FIO DAPs. The current line, the M line, has a much more simpler sound than the X line used to have. So this with a FIO M player can result in a very high-end kind of sound. So you are getting a very good sound out of them. And it's quite enjoyable as an overall setup. Not quite as enjoyable to strap this to an already thickish DAC amplifier. I mean, those two strapped together are already quite thick. Strapping them to a smartphone gets crazy thick. It would look something like this. So you probably do not want to go like this on the street with this kind of thick stack. This is too thick for me to consider practical. So no two things. But having this attached to a player which has a line out is awesome idea. I actually think I would be using it that way. I think I will mention it again once I receive the FIO M6. It is in transportation right now. Should be landing in Romania soon. So probably we'll do a little recap about XDSD by the time the M6 gets here. I hope you have enjoyed this video. I hope it was fun. This is a new type of video I'm trying to do. Please leave a comment in the comment section to let me know how you'd like me to improve my videos, what you'd like me to review next, things like that. Please let me know how I can be of help to you, like if you need advice or such. This will have an in-depth review coming to Audiophile Heaven. Do not worry. I'll have my typical in-depth reviews done about all products presented on YouTube, unless I specify so. So do not worry, you'll get to hear a full in-depth opinion. I cannot talk quite as in-depth during a YouTube video because I am coming with those on spot. So I don't have quite the same amount of time to think like and do the same complex comparisons I do while writing a review. Now, I hope you have a lovely weekend there. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe if you like this video. I hope you have a lovely weekend there, as I said, and I hope to see you soon. Bye.